It is the unique concept of salaried graduate couples permanently stationed in the villages to steer the campaign. Anil and Shalini Shukla are one such couple. Anil Shukla, an MA in Business Economics, worked as an assistant professor before he came to work in village Behar. He's the nodal point for the weaver Mangali, for whom he ensures regular supplies and payment. The comfort level of the former migrant, Mangali, back in the village, is directly linked to the efficiency of the Shukla couple. Among their many activities, Anil and Shalini coordinate with health workers, who provide indigenous medicines for routine ailments. They maintain daily records, spend informal time with the people, and are constantly working towards spreading awareness.
They are taught, don't depend upon anybody. Don't depend upon the planning or the government. Nobody is going to improve you. You will have to be self-reliant. Unless and until you become self-reliant, no economic development is possible.
The Green Revolution of India brought about self-sufficiency in food grains. But the population has grown faster than food grain production. And with a growing population, land has been consistently divided into smaller fragments. Cultivators and agricultural laborers form about 65% of the working population. But even today, nearly 70% of the cropped land remains without irrigation and is solely dependent on the monsoon. Is all this an echo from a warning voice of the past? Way back in 1830, a British Governor General Metcalfe said, "The union of village communities has contributed more than any other to the preservation of the peoples of India. And I dread everything that has a tendency to break them up." 70 years later, Gandhi wrote his treatise on self-rule for India. He was convinced that if the villages perished, India would perish too. Political leaders like Nehru did not disregard Gandhi, but firmly believed that the river of change cannot be stopped and India could not revert to primitiveness. Nanaji is convinced that rural India can once again flourish. He believes when people uplift themselves, politics and administration itself will change, and the system will have to deliver.
Agriculture and industry together can not only reduce, it can wipe out the poverty totally. I am showing it. You go to the villages and you can see. Now the uneconomic holdings, we have made economic, you go and see.
The efforts of the agricultural science centers are intensive. All 80 villages under the self-reliance campaign were mapped and analyzed with inputs from the villagers. The aim is to fill the gap between indigenous and scientific methods. In village Ludhwara, Revati Raman is proud of his model 2.5 acre farm. Revati owns 10 acres of land, but as he says,
I have 4 sons. They will get a small share of 2.5 acres each. So I am experimenting with this model for their future, giving them inspiration.
3/4 of agricultural land in India is uneconomical. The lives of marginal farmers can be transformed if such model farms are replicated with support like seed replacement.
In 7 सालों के अंदर जो बीज का रिप्लेसमेंट हुआ है उसके हिसाब से 94-95 का जो प्रोडक्शन हमारा 2 क्विंटल पर हेक्टेयर का था आज बढ़कर के 4-5 क्विंटल पर हेक्टेयर का हो चुका है।
But millions of marginalized and landless farmers like Rehman must survive. Rehman lives in village Budha Se Marwar.
We were five brothers. Naturally, I got less than an acre. But prosperity has come since we started poultry farming.
The agricultural center trained Rehman's wife in backyard poultry farming. Today, Badrunnisa is an example for Rehman's brothers and other villagers. If there is economic benefit, she says, others will follow. Gandhi spoke of democracy and village development in terms of oceanic circles. Today, it is fashionably called the ripple effect. Namdev and Gond tribal Shiv Charan both live in village Patnakala. Patnakala was not part of the Mili watershed project, but the people had seen the impact in neighboring areas. They wanted it for themselves too. Namdev and his wife, the graduate couple, have worked here for almost 5 years. Namdev's greatest joy is the water channel that the community built.
With their own engineering wisdom, they redirected the water source through a 4 kilometer long water channel. Every field has water now. People have really tasted bread made of wheat.
The question then is, can targets be really achieved in 5 years?
5 saal kisi bhi ek kaam ke liye ye paryapt samay hai aur hum logo ne ye anubhav kiya hai ki samuhik prayatn se samaj ke sahyog se kisi bhi kaam ko 5 varsh mein pura kiya ja sakta hai.
Obviously, it is not plans but people who matter. The bureaucracy of Free India inherited an unsustainable trend that distances people from plans and policies. Chitrakoot once again raises the question Gandhi raised at the time of independence. Will India humbly step back into its villages for a secure future?